You gonna check out my, oh. You gonna check me out?
Hi, my name is Angela Taylor, and this is Taylor Homestead Soap. So normally on this channel, I do soap. But about once a month, I change it over to fiber. And boy, do I have a cool fiber video for you today. So I found an alpaca farm. And while we were there, we saw 50 alpacas. He's got, one of his alpacas has won multiple awards for his fleece, and his name is Prince, and you'll get to see that here in a minute. But here's the cool thing about it, ready? He gave me Prince's wool to wash, dry, card, spin, and make cool things out of. Now he wants it back, obviously. But I'm doing it for him because I thought that was really a really cool deal. Now I did get something in return. It's not like I got it. I did it for free. I didn't. But we've got a really cool thing going on here, and I am super excited to show you the process in which I went through for the wool that I received. So, and it's raw wool. I had to wash it. It was dirty because they like to take dust baths, so it was very dusty. So the one thing I did leave out of this video is the washing. And when you wash alpaca fleece, you have to use a really gentle soap. I used Dawn soap, and you put it in pretty hot water, and then, and you don't, well, you put it in really hot water, and then you put it in kind of warm, but not super hot water. And then you go back and forth two or three times. So that process I didn't show you, but I did show you in this video the carding and the spinning and what I'm making out of it. So enjoy. If you like what you see, please subscribe to the channel, leave a comment below, and give me a big thumbs up. Thank you for watching.
My wife Linnell, Joe and Linnell Porter from Awesome Alpacas in Monroe, North Carolina.
And this is Kate and Angela, and we have come to see all their awesome alpacas. How many alpacas do you have?
We have approximately 50 right now.
And how many babies do you have?
I'm sorry?
How many babies do
babies.
You have?
Babies. I think there's 12 or 13 babies right now that we have.
Fantastic.
Just okay. Talk about Prince Royal?
Yes, please.
This is Prince Royal. He has the distinction of having received the Spirit of Industry Award at age 8, which is, to my knowledge, the oldest that alpaca stud has received the Spirit of Industry Award, which is only awarded 4 times a year nationally. After he received that award, I looked to see, and I couldn't find another that had received it at that age. But the Spirit of Industry Award is given to animals that retain their fineness even after they get older, and particularly with studs that are breeding and testosterone's flowing and they typically get coarser. His fleece did not get coarser, and so he was awarded that Spirit of Industry Award at age 8 because of his fleece fineness. We've got some nice babies out of him. He's a fawn, and he produces almost nothing but fawn. Many times I've tried to get a gray out of him, and only I have to skip a generation to make it happen by getting some gray put in there. But this is Prince, and he's, gosh, I guess he's 10 probably now. So, he's a good boy.
He's a good boy. And here are all the males on this side. You have fawns and grays. And then on this side, you can see here all the girls and all of their babies.
And then, you know, we have most of them are pretty docile. Lay back. The one that's just lying down there right over there where she is now, just lay down right there where she's cleaning that water. That's Rebel. He is a very, very sweet boy. He is really, really laid back.
Oh, they're so pretty.
What sound do they make?
Well, you heard.
You like a sheep sound, don't you?
Kind of. It's not a sheep sound, but it's a...
It's a hummer. They're true hummers.
Hi.
A little...
You're so quiet. I wish Emmy was as quiet as you. Oh, look at these babies over here. Oh, look at you.
Bella's baby is My Goodness.
My Goodness. Yep. The baby's name, which one's My Goodness? This one? No.
The white face over there. She's gone. She was right at the fence. And now
I see her now. Hi, My Goodness.
The little boy that helps me here, he calls her, Oh My Goodness. I said, no, it's not Oma. It's just My Goodness.
My Goodness.
They have a soft pad instead of a hoof. So that's a soft pad, which makes them very, very environmentally friendly, you know, not impact the soil.
So when you cart alpaca, the first thing you do is you spread the fiber out. You get it to be a little lofty is the goal. So you spread it all out, and then you bring it over to this drum carter here, and you pull the wheel this way, and you drum it this way. And Kate, can you see that? It goes in between here. Now, here's the thing. Then you take this animal-looking brush, and you go through like this. Get all this off. We don't want any wasted alpaca. All right. Then I have to take it off with my very broken stick. Oops. All right. Now, I'm going to do this again because I want to make sure I get as much of the little bits out as possible. This has been washed. I washed and I dried this, but it still has like a little piece of hay in it. So I'm taking this through again. It's gone through once, so I'm going to take it through again. So I'm pulling the wheel back, turning the drum carter. It's pulling it through. Now, look at that hot mess. So what, I'm taking this brush thing. It's like a dog brush. It's never been used on a dog. And I'm doing this. This is to get all of it nice and straight so that I can then spin it. Like so.
And what exactly does that do?
Well, it makes it all nice and straight so that then it turns into these, what we call bumps. And now I can take this fiber and put it through my spinning wheel. It's nice and straight. And this is so soft. You just want to like lay in it. It's so soft. So soft. So all of this that you see here came from Prince, who is from Awesome Alpaca Farm in Monroe, North Carolina. I'm going to take that and spin it up for them and make some cool stuff. So what I'm doing now is I'm taking Prince's. What I did is you saw me card up Prince's fleece, and now what I'm doing is I'm spinning it. So all I'm doing is pulling it out, and then the spinning wheel is pulling it in. Cool, huh? You guys, I so want alpacas now. I can't believe how I'm like trying to conjure. I'm trying to figure out, what can I do with my land? I've got an acre. I could have two alpacas. How would I do that? Isn't that terrible of me? I don't have time right now. I mean, I really don't when the school year starts, but maybe in a couple of years. Look at this, guys. So this is what I have made from the alpaca. This is a Tanzanian lattice stitch, and it's about 6 inches wide. I'm not quite finished with it yet. I'm about maybe a third of the way finished with it. And this is what I'm making out of Prince Royal right now. Again, if you like what you saw, please subscribe to the channel, give me a big thumbs up, and leave a comment below. Thank you for watching.